The hard part about making a circuit is like it's problem solving. You make a mistake, you got to fix that mistake.
It's a circuit. My name is Angela.
Today's class was just really hard because we were doing a project on lights and having two lights both turned on, turning one off without turning the other one off, and we just experimented with a lot of different parts.
What if I switched out?
It's just cool to see that, you know, you can replace one of these with some type of metal or material and it'll work the same type. So yeah.
Can you see it's broken?
Yeah, my kids go to the school as well. So the ability to go to the school and volunteer where they are is great. Anything really ranges. That's my wife. Yeah, she's the PNC president. She comes and delivers the food. Yeah. I'm basically Livia. Today, I think we're looking at series and parallel circuits. So we get the kids to build series and parallel circuits and see the effect of putting a switch in there, you know, what will turn off, what will turn on, or what will stay on, you know, and just how Western Power is a parallel network versus a series network.
I found it pretty cool to have somebody that you can just like ask those sort of questions, and like he would know the answer and you'd have the answer.
We've had all sorts from, you know, what it is we do to why did they split up Western Power from Sequoia, to, you know, what's an insulator, what conducts well.
Yeah, Chris. He lives near me too, so that's cool.
Other one goes off.
I found it really cool that just like a printer and a computer can make something like that. And it was just quite amazing.
We traditionally haven't even used anything like this, definitely not 3D printing to combine technology with electricity.
Look on the board as to what you need to make your circuit.
And the kids explore the role of engineers, how circuitry works, and then with the end game to producing their own energy or powered city. And they need to decide whether they're going to use, you know, renewable energy forms or fossil fuels, and then using that print 3D models of those components. So the, you know, the transformers, the power stations, the wind farms, those sorts of things.
Yeah, I just want to learn how to 3D print, learn some new stuff in science. So yeah.